Today's topic is reversers and motor contactors control circuit. In EMU and MEMU, two reversers are provided. They are K1 and K2. K1 reverser controls TM1 and TM2 traction motor fields. K2 reverser controls TM3 and TM4 traction motor fields. K1 and K2 are operated by reverser key MPJ and its positions are forward, neutral and reverse. K1 reverser is located in SG1 and K2 reverser is located in SG2. To operate reversers, the following conditions are to be fulfilled. 15 amps MCB MPT should be non-condition, BL should be unlocked condition, control switch should be on condition, BIV should be fully turned on condition, any one of the MCS should be in normal position. Press MPT and move reverser key to forward or reverse direction and then keep MPT to shunt position. Then the battery supply through 15 amps MCB MPT, BL interlock, control switch on interlock, BIV interlock, DMH 1 and 2 interlock, MPT close on position, reverser forward interlock, if the reverser is in forward position, through MCS 1 and 2 close to normal position, then K1F, K2F coils will energize. If the reverser is set in reverse direction, then through reverser reverse interlock, MCS 1 and 2 close in normal position and K1R, K2R reverser coils will energize. And when the reverser coils are energized, reversers will set as per the repeat direction. There are four traction motors in EMU and MEMU. Each motor is provided with contactors on positive side as well as negative side. M1 is the positive contactor for traction motor 1, M2 is the positive contactor for TM2, M3 is the positive contactor for TM3, M4 is the positive contactor for TM4. Motor contactors can be isolated by motor cutout switches MCS1 and MCS2. M1, M2, M3, M4 are the positive side contactors for traction motors. Negative contactors. Each traction motor is also provided with a negative contactor and they are controlled by MCS1 and MCS2. NC1 is the negative contactor for TM1, NC2 is the negative contactor for TM2, NC3 is the negative contactor for TM3. NC4 is the negative contactor for TM4. When MPT kept in on position, that is shunt, half power, full power, then first negative contactors close and then positive contactors close. Negative contacts also can be isolated by MCS1 and MCS2 when required. M1, M2, NC1, NC2 are located in SG1. M3, M4, NC3, NC4 are located in SG2. To close motor contactors, the following conditions are to be fulfilled. 15 amps MCB MPT should be in on condition. BL should be unlocked condition, control switch should be in on condition, BIV should be fully turned on position, any one of the MCS should be in normal position, press MPT and operate reverser key to forward or reverse as required and then keep MPT on shunt position, then K1, K2 reversers will be set as per MPJ position. And then negative contactors close first and motor contactors close. Once again, let us see how the supply goes to motor contactors. Press MPT and keep reverser in required direction, and then keep MPT on shunt position. Now the battery supply through 15 amps MCB, BL interlock, control interlock, BIB interlock, DMH 1 and 2 interlocks, MPT closes in on position interlocks, reverser forward interlock. Any one of the MCS should be in normal position. Through that, when reversers are set, K1F K2F interlock closes, and then through parking brake governor closed, control governor closed, equipment governor closed, CVIR normally closed interlock, TTR normally closed interlock, RFR normally open interlock, OL1 OL2 normally closed interlock. Supply goes to through MCS closes on 1 out and 1 and 2 out. NC1 closes, then NC1 interlock closes on M1, M1 also closes. At the same time, the supply also through MCS1 closes on 2 out and 1 and 2 out, NC2 closes, and NC2 interlock closes on M2, then M2 also closes. Simultaneously, the supply also through normally core interlock OL3 and OL4, and through MCS closes 3 out and 3 and 4 out, NC3 interlock closes, NC3 contact closes, and NC3 normally open interlock closes on M3, M3 also closes. Simultaneously, the supply through MCS closes on 4 out and 3 and 4 out, NC4 contact closes, and NC4 normally open interlock closes on M4. And M4 also closes. Now this is how motor contactors close. Motor contactor switches are MCS1, which controls M1, M2, NC1, NC2. MCS2 controls M3, M4, NC3, NC4. MCS1 positions are normal. TM1 and TM2 are in service. 1 out TM1 isolated, 2 out TM2 isolated, 1 and 2 out TM1 and TM2 isolated. MCS2 positions are normal. TM3 and TM4 are in service. 3 out TM3 isolated, 4 out TM4 isolated, 3 and 4 out TM3 and TM4 isolated. Today we learned about reversers and motor contacts control circuit. Thank you all.